Trust Fund. All of these kids are orphans whose lives have been affected by AIDS. Your money has helped provide crucial support and also to fund the adults who look after them. The most heartbreaking statistic is that there are over 2 million children like these who are affected. The people of Africa desperately need our support. Please call 1-877-IDLE-AID. That's 1-877-436-5243. Thank you for caring.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Jimmy Kimmel.
Well, thank you. I've been asked tonight to introduce Simon Cowell. Actually, a lot of people were asked to introduce him, but no one else would do it. Hi, Simon. Simon Cowell is the reason Governor Schwarzenegger must work to secure the borders of this country. All the good feelings about the British Mary Poppins brought here, he has undone. This event tonight is for a wonderful cause, but I think we should set just a little bit of the money that we raise tonight aside to buy Simon a shirt that fits him. Simon, I know you've had that black V-neck since the fourth grade, but and I'm sure there's an emotional attachment, but it's time to let it go. It really is. So. You know, they say people like and relate to Simon because he says what the rest of us are thinking, but if that's the case, why hasn't he said anything about the fact that his nipples are the size of pepper mills? On many nights, it looks like you are smuggling the Olsen twins in under your shirt. Fortunately for Simon, they do draw attention away from that ridiculous haircut, honestly. Who parts that for you, Moses? Is that a hairstyle in England? Because I've never seen it here before. Simon, you make $40 million a year. It's time to step up from supercuts. It really is. But back to Simon's nipples, if I may. You know, people sometimes think Paula is crying on the show. No, it's his nipples keep poking her in the eyes. Truth be told, Simon, I know Simon, he's a good man. He supports a number of charities, not just this one in D.C. He supports PETA in their work against cruelty to animals. Simon feels strongly that cruelty should be reserved exclusively for the contestants on this show. But the fact is, American Idol without Simon Cowell would be like Christmas without the Grinch. It would be like a picnic without ants. It would be like Ryan Seacrest without the faux hawk. And I think I speak for all of America when I say, let's see you sing something, Simon. And button your shirt. Ladies and gentlemen, Simon Cowell.
In America, there are over 50 million people without the necessary health care and insurance. 50 million of those are children. Children just like yours. I traveled to New York to visit a group of doctors and nurses who are providing desperately needed health care to homeless and low-income families from a fleet of mobile medical units, paid for with your donations.
We thought that it would be best to bring the care to the population and to make sure that these people weren't falling through the cracks and that they were getting comprehensive care.
One family who rely on the work of the Children's Health Fund is Irene and her two children, Vanessa and Macha.
Thank you for allowing me in.
No problem. Thank you for coming to my home.
After being evicted from their apartment, the family is crammed into two rooms at Irene's mum's. Macho spent 2 years in a wheelchair. He's just got out of the hospital where he had 4 pins inserted into his knee. And despite having rheumatoid arthritis, Vanessa has to sleep on the sofa.
You know, it's hard for me because of the fact that young people should be able to run, they should be able to play, you know. We're supposed to be active, and, you know, that's not the case for me anymore.
And Irene, you haven't been well yourself, have you?
No, I have lupus.
Which so, is?
It's an autoimmune body disease.
Yeah.
In the beginning, I didn't want my kids to know that mommy's sick, you know. That's not something you go and tell them.
And what would have happened without the clinic?
Who knows? She'd probably be...
Excuse me. She'd probably be deformed.
Hey.
I'm sorry.
I just think that if I had to do it by myself, it would have been worse. It would have been worse.
Deep breath. All right, my hands might be cold.
Tell America what you'd like them to do.
Oh, I would like for them to just donate, and just keep giving, give from the heart, because you're giving to the children and those families that are being helped like mine. I'm sorry.
You can help us to help families like